Right now in the whole world, we are living in a very difficult situation. You don't know what is going to happen with this pandemic. You don't know what is going to happen with life in general because we are living with an uncertainty that some people cannot face. A lot of people are dying. A lot of people don't believe this situation is stronger than everyone, so those people don't follow any measure the government took in order to give safe the population. In the case of Dominican Republic, in my opinion, the country is divided in three parts. The parts where the people who take care of themselves following the preventive measures are, the part where the people who don't care about the situation are, and also the last but not least, the part where the people who believe in this situation but are affected by ignorant people who carry the virus into their houses are. Definitely, this is a very difficult situation that has been affecting all the areas, especially education. I'm a college student and I have felt different feelings. Feelings that have caused on me anxiety and also negative thoughts of that what I have the ability to do. It was different when we had the opportunity to go outside without preoccupations, when we could hang out with our friends in order to get away the things that happened, and also when we had contact with our teachers who since the first day this pandemic started have been there supporting and motivating us to keep making an effort. But now, everything is different. In order not to get the COVID-19, we have had to lock away ourselves. But what about our mental health? I'm a college student, like I previously said, and I know for sure the anxiety that causes us to be at the same place every time, without having the opportunity to get away or to feel alive after spending the whole week doing homeworks and college things. As I mentioned, the education have changed the modality that we take classes, in this case presential classes into virtual classes. So the teachers, even though they have been there supporting us in everything we need, have been forced to supplant presential classes, assigning a lot of homework that causes us anxiety because we don't have the enough time to do them, but also they don't have enough time to correct them. So both are feeling stressed by this time. I'm sure some of you feel stressed because you think that if you don't spend the whole day in front of a computer doing homework, your students' quality are going to change. Your quality is going to be affected, but what is more important, your mental health or a grade? In my opinion, both are important, so you have to make a balance to be excellent at the university but also excellent treating yourself. Keep in mind that we have to take care of ourselves. Because or in this time, or you can get the COVID-19, or you can develop a psychological disorder. So we have to take care of ourselves. The message that I want to transmit with this video consists to learn about finding yourself. Remember that you are not alone, since every people or a lot of people around the world are going through the same situation. One day, one of my sisters told me that since this pandemic started, I was not the same. Because before it arrives to the world, I used to do many things with her, such as watch TV. But after, I was far away from her. So that day, I started to think that the things that I was doing weren't correct, because maybe when she needed me more, I wasn't there.
Some tips that I want to recommend you in order to change together this anxiety that we have due to COVID-19 and the hard academic law are: find yourself. Take a time to think about yourself, about the things that you like to do in order not to feel bored or tired of being at the same place every time. This time that you take for yourself, it is going to be quality time. So you can, for example, cook something delicious for yourself, you can share time with your family, and also you can read your favorite book. Make a study schedule. I know this can be hard to do, but if you don't do it, you are going to develop a psychological anxiety disorder, and by the time this pandemic gets away, you are going to need a psychologist. So I really think that it is good to use, for example, an agenda where you can write all the things that you have to do with the day. So while you are doing them, you can mark with a check the things that you complete or the assignments that you finish. If you, for example, don't have this type of agenda or don't want to buy one of these ones, you can, for example, use an online application, in this case, Google Calendar. Identify a purpose for each assignment you do. To make every assignment more interesting and helpful for yourself, before doing it, identify in which aspect it is going to be helpful for your professional life. With every goal achieved or with every assignment finished, you have to give you a reward to yourself, in this case to motivate yourself. So that reward could be, for example, a rest of 20-25 minutes where you can, for example, watch a video, or you can play a video game, or you can share time with your family, and also where you can prepare a coffee for yourself. Make happy the people you love. Sometimes we always think in ourselves, but what about the people that we have around us that we love and who love us too? We have to try to make a balance to share time with them, so make happy the people you love. Make priority the assignment that needs to be uploaded first. I know this can be hard because with this new modality, the virtual modality, the teachers have been assigning a lot of homework. But if you give priority to the assignment that needs to be uploaded first, I know and I really think it is going to be better in the future.
I think that if we follow these tips, we are going to feel better in a world affected by a pandemic. Remember that I'm going through the same situation, so you are not alone, because I want to help you and a lot of people around the world that are feeling the same want to help you too. Let's change this difficult situation with love, security, confidence, good treat, responsibility, respect, but also then one of the most important, the confidence in God. My name is Ana Richelle Tejada Cáceres. I'm 19 years old and I never thought that by this age I was going to live during a pandemic situation. But I know for sure that if we make an effort and work hard, together we can make it. Thank you for watching.